Gentlemen, good morning. How's everybody doing out there? Hashtag SBTV Nation. This is Rob the Mad Hatter, and we are sitting here talking on our 300th episode, baby. That's right, man. We have come a long ass way, and you know what, man? To all our friends and our fans out there, to hashtag SBTV Nation, we love you to death, guys, and you guys have made this happen for us, man. You have heard my voice 300 damn times, kid. Okay? That's all I got to say about that. I'm very excited about the show today. Got my man Vince Parker that's going to be calling it a little bit. And, I'm going to mess around with the format a little bit. Pretty excited about what we got going on, guys. What's going to happen basically is we are going to be kind of just making some changes a little bit, doing some stuff, kind of shaking it up a little bit for you, because you know what? I think you guys deserve it, and I'm very, very excited about what we got going on. Very, very big stuff, and I'll tell you right now, man, when football comes, that's all I got to say about that. Who's ready for football out there, by the way? That's all I got to ask about that, guys. Big shout out to everybody that's on Twitter. First of all, just to let you know, my boy The Dream, he could not be on today. He's missing the party. Listen, all I got to say is this, all right? My boy has sacrificed so much out of his life to be on here with me every day, okay? And I got to be honest with you, all right? You know, he gets animated at times, and you know, some people love him, some people hate him, whatever. But you know what? At the end of the day, I love that dude to death. And you know what? He has made more sacrifices than you guys ever can imagine. That's all I got to say, man. So big shout out to The Dream Kid. I know that you're going to be listening later on, man. Listen, I love you from the bottom of my heart, man. And I can't wait to do all these big things that we got going on together, my man. That's all I got to say about that. So, big ups to, let's see, Moneyline Hunter, yeah, man, Guns N' Roses to start off the show, kid. You know what? I heard that yesterday. I said, oh, I got to do this, man. So, let's see who's out on Twitter today. We've got Holiday. I got Smokey Rodriguez. I got Snoopy Betts. I got D. I got Jason Riley. Let's see who else I've got. I got 714 Cousin. I got the Canadian Capper. I got Smokey. I've got Papa Smurf. What's up, kid? I've been meaning to reach out to you, find out where the hell you been, man. I got Sergio Rodriguez. I got Spot Bet. I've got, I got Heavy 365. Vegas Girl 92661. You know what? I want to do a females episode. And you know what, sweetheart? You get up every day in the morning in Vegas to listen to us bright and early. You know what? I think I want to kind of get you on the show. Hit me up later on. We'll have the conversation. I got Tip Talker, hashtag SBTV Nation. I got G Rose. I got Big Mike. I got Boston Boy. I got Jeff Ryan. Wow, man. Unbelievable. Let's see who else, man. Bengal T, Face Kicker, Bully Sports Cards. Let's see, man. Triple B, what is going on, guys? Good morning to you. And guys, you know, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Thank you for doing everything that you do for us, man. Whether it's, you know, retweeting us, whether it's sending us donations, whether it's the whole package. You know what, man? Guys, you know what? You're keeping this dream alive for me. And you know what? I am going to fight till the death to make it happen for each and every one. You know, not just you, but for myself as well, man, because I kind of want to do this full time. I got a big smile on my face, ear to ear, man, just feeling really good, and I'm feeling really good about last night's card. Let's talk about Hatterball real quick, all right? So, we went 2-1 on the night, okay? Should have went 3-1, or 3-0, rather, man, but, kid, we had the over 7 in the Stanks and Washington Nasties game. I'm going to start off by talking about my loss. How about that? We had a 2-1 game in the first inning. All we needed was 7 runs for a push and 8 runs for a winner, right? though, the game ends 3-2 with this umpire. Let me tell you something. You guys are out there capping your games and all that. You know, take a look at the umpire strike zones as you're doing it, because for me, I should have got out at that point. Once I saw, you know, fourth, fifth inning where this umpire strike zone was, because he was so favoring the pitchers, man. This dude was calling strikes. I mean, if you looked at the last strikeout with A-Rod looking, the ball was like up above his stomach, like inside, man. He called, he struck him out looking. I was like, ha, ha, ha. But anyway, hey, that's in the rearview mirror. Let's talk about the two wins. We started off with the Houston Astros yesterday, and Houston Astros was a stomach ache for a minute, 1-1, and then as soon as it was, boom, we got a two-run shot, I want to say, and we ended up winning the game 6-1, so that was a laugher, and we had the K-Sizzle Royals go over the 7.5 and pretty much almost did it on their own, scoring 7 runs by themselves to win 7-1, man. And I got news for you guys. This K-Sizzle team, dude, I think they're going to get into the World Series. And I think they got a good shot at winning. I really do, man. I mean, you got to look at them, dude. I mean, it's all team baseball. It's all a little bit small ball. But last year was more small ball than this year. Now they're starting to really knock the ball around, man. So it's pretty crazy. So I have a feeling that we're going to be getting invested into the K-Sizzle Royals this year. But let's talk real quick about what happened last night. Let's talk about the Cleveland Cavaliers and my boy LeBron. It wasn't so much the LeBron show. It was more the J.R. Smith show than anything, kid. LeBron, he did score 31 points. I got to give it to him. But, you know, that's common for him. That's my boy. But I really need Atlanta to win this series, guys, to cash. But, hey, you know what? At the end of the day, it is what it is. J.R. Smith goes on a tear. 28 points, 8 three-pointers. He had hands in his face for days, man. I don't know, man. I was looking at the highlights. You know, I was kind of doing the whole thing, you know, kind of chill with the bride a little bit, do my thing or whatever with her, a little bit of wine on Wednesdays is kind of what I do. And I saw the highlights, and it was unbelievable what happened there. So, hey, big shout-out to the Cleveland Cavaliers. And, you know, now they're up 1-0, and they stole home court back. So, I don't know. I think Atlanta's got an issue. It kind of almost looked like, you know, just by seeing some highlights and stuff like that, like Atlanta was kind of out of their element there. I mean, don't you think? I mean, I don't know, guys. You know what? I really hope and pray that they can make it happen, but it looked pretty ugly. It looked pretty ugly from there. Let's go over to the NHL. What happened? Oh, before we do that, Damari Carroll is one of the big scorers for Atlanta. He messed up his knee pretty bad. I think he had a hyperextended knee or whatever. So, oh, that's going to make it even worse. He's been like their leading scorer in like 6 of the last playoff games. I'm not sure how many they played. I want to say it was 13. So about half of them, he's been their leading scorer. So I think we got a little bit of an issue there. So we'll see what happens. Shooting over to the ice. I got to play this track, Animals, for my boy Dank. He's been hitting me up, telling me to play this. And you know what, dude? I finally did it, man, because I am feeling so damn excited today, kid. I want to jump out of my damn skin. I got Direct Sports Solutions. I got Philly Picks out there. I got Benjamin Rowe. You know what's cool is that I'm starting to know you guys by your pictures. I don't have to, like, click on it to see what your profile name is. So pretty cool about that. Big Splee Picks, who's been absolutely destroying it out there. I got Slick Rick. I got Must Seller Sports Bets. What is up? Wow, guys. How about Tampa Biscuit? The Tampa Biscuit Lightning come back and win the game in overtime with the Rangers. My God. I mean, I was looking at it. I was popping in and out. Rangers were up 1-0. And then I see Tampa Biscuit up 4-3. And then I see the tie game at 4. Then I see Tampa Biscuit up 5-4. And then I see the Rangers tie it up with like 2 minutes left. I'm like, ah, unbelievable game. If you guys had the under, I could hear you screaming from my crib, I'll tell you that much. But, hey, if you had the over, you were laughing all day. And big ups to the Queen of Odds. It's been absolutely ripping up the hockey. That's all I got to say about that. So, I don't know, man. I mean, it was Kucherov that hit the last one at the overtime or whatever. So, hey, big ups to them. And hopefully the Rangers can come back here. I don't know. It's going to be tough. You know, like the Dream said, man, they always come back with adversity. They got to be, like, down or something to be good. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, we'll see what happens from there. But let's... Canadian Capper said, Dream is the effing man. F all the haters. I love it, man. I love it. All right, dude. So, let's... You know what? I don't do scores, guys. But you know what? Hatterball wants to have a little conversation about the MLBs or what happened last night because... You know what? There was a couple of things that transpired that we had talked about on the show. And I think it's imperative that we have that conversation. So let me just pull up my my ESPN here on my scores and see what happened last night. So looking at this, as you know, the Houston Astros weren't having it yesterday. The Red Sox, you know, this is why I tell you not to take them in futures. I mean, they lost to the Texas Rangers at home, man. I told you that Jeff Locke for the Pittsburgh Pirates wasn't, it was crazy for him to be given 150 juice. I said he wasn't, they had no business doing it. I did not bet the game, but hey, it obviously came true what I had to say. We talked about the Stanks and Nasties. The Tigers, if you guys chased on the Tigers, hey man, you know what, I give you a lot of credit, but I wouldn't have did it myself, but they did win the game. And St. Lucia was not having it with the Mets. They win 9-0, kid. Damn. Unbelievable. The Braves win. Let's see what else we had. Philadelphia Phillies, they win that series. I'm just saying. Just saying. Philadelphia Phillies are not that bad. And the Cubbies, too. And the Dodgers didn't show up. I guess the bats just ain't having it. So, you know, expect the Dodgers to come back at some point here. I have a feeling that they're going to make it happen. So, you know what, guys? You've been getting punched in the face. I know my man Sugar Shane Verdinius put out something real funny about the Dodgers. But, hey, you know what? I still think they're one of the best teams in the NL. But, surprisingly, I mean, and big ups to Dr. Dan, by the way. I got to give him a lot of credit as well for, you know, putting us on the map with the baseball last year, pointing out this K-Sizzle team. You know what? Dr. Dan's been sacrificing a lot as well. He's working crazy hours. He's going to be on Saturday, man. Guys, we are one day away from the weekend, baby. Because tomorrow, I know most of you guys are going to be checking out. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be checking out early to kind of beat the traffic and get the hell out of Dodge. But you know what? And it's going to be checking out basically how you guys were checking out when you were watching the Houston Astros and A's game on your phone yesterday. Don't deny it. I know a lot of you cats are out there, you know, you punch the clock and, you know, you're kind of escaping to the bathroom at work looking at the score. I know all you junkies, man. Come on. It's me here. That's all I got to say about that. I'm sure all you guys were doing that, man. So, hey, you know what? I'm glad you got that early matinee money and hopefully none of your bosses caught you out and hopefully none of you told your bosses to kick rocks. That's all I got to say about that. So, guys, here's what your boy has to do. Did I ask you already? Are you ready for football? Because I'm so ready for football, man. I got a couple of trips coming up, man. I'm very excited about. And we're going to go from there. So I'm going to switch it up a little bit. I want to do something here. You know what? I'm going to do this, all right? Because I'm going to give a special shout out to the fake fam, Crush the Bookie, the whole package out there. My man Crush the Bookie's been on 870 nights or something like that, nonstop by himself. And he gave me a little bit of an idea, so I got to give him all the credit in the world for this. So big ups to Crush the Bookie on that. But while I look at the card, I'm going to play a track with vocals. I'm going to give myself a 3-minute break, okay? So, guys, you know what? Stay tuned because your boy needs to take a look at the MLB card and get an idea of what's happening. And I got to put a DM out to my guest, Vince Parker, that's going to be calling in real soon. So, taking a little break in the action, guys. And I know, you know, most of you guys, every time I play this on the instrumental, you guys love me for it. And you know what? I'm going to play with the vocals today. So, hey, much love to the SBTV Nation, kid. Hashtag SBTV Nation taking over the damn world. That's all I got to say about that. Here you go, baby.
Some people want me to be heads or tails. I say no way, try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales. I just won't play, letting my life get away.
train me like an animal. Better keep your eye on my every move. There's no need to be so damn cruel. Baby, you got nothing to prove.
Episode 300 of the biggest show in the world. Hey guys, you know what, man? Listen, that song sends goosebumps down my spine, and I had to do it for the SBTV Nation. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna put a special DM out to my boy Vince Parker. Vince, I know you're listening live, baby. Why don't you give your boy a call? Let's break down some of this MLBs and see what the hell we got going on. Because I'm looking at the card and I'm having a little trouble with it. I got to be honest with you, man. Looks kind of nasty. But I'm going to just start while I'm waiting for him and see what we got here. We got the Arizona Diamondbacks coming into the Miami Marlins. Arizona has Archie Bradley on the mound. Miami has Matt Latos. Miami minus 140 with an under-over of 7.5. Guys, you really think this Marlins team has any business giving that kind of juice? I'm just saying, man. I'm just saying. Let me get my man in here and see what he's got to say. Mr. Vince Parker, are you there?
I'm here, buddy. How's everything going, man?
Kid, I'm flying today.
Dude, I love it. I love the new format. I love the energy. Love the way everything's going. SBTV Nation, what's happening, guys?
Oh. Happy 300. Kid, hell yeah, man. 300 episodes, and you know what? We booked you, and just so happy to have you on, dude. I know a lot of people are listening in and want to hear what you got to say, my brother.
Man, I appreciate it. It's been a while. I think the last time that I was on that we talked was back in January, you know. So we've been moving along and things have been going well. We've been very blessed and have started MLB exactly the way that we wanted. Closing out basketball has been a little dusty, but we've made everything back through baseball, you know. So just plus money week after plus money week, and just wanted to kind of come on and run through some things with the guys and just kind of let them in on our process and the way that we do things. And if they take something away from it and be able to make a little bit of money, then it's all good for everybody.
Oh, that's sweet, man. Hey, I want to share with the nation what the hell you, myself, and Tony been going through, like, on a nightly basis. So, guys, what end up happening is these dudes always send me their plays, right? And what ends up happening is these cats always go against me, man. It's like, and it's not intentional. It's just like they send me, I usually, you know, most of the time I take favorites, but they'll send me the run line on the dog. And I'm like, yo, I'm on the opposite side, dude. You know what I'm saying? But I'm on the money line. And then what ends up happening is we always catch the middle. That's sick, dude. You guys went on the run line, the +1.5, and I catch the money line because I like getting involved in stomach ache games, I guess. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, it ends up working out pretty well, man. So, big ups to you guys for, you know, sending me your plays. And, hey, man, I know you've been doing well. So, talk to me about what you got going on right now.
Yeah, so we've been blessed. What I wanted to kind of do is just something a little bit different. I know I've been on shows before, and I know y'all have had guests on, and they kind of came on and, you know, broke down some games and gave away some picks and not really went through the process. And that's all, you know, good and fine because a lot of those cash and it's good, easy money. But what I wanted to kind of do is just run through a little bit of a daily routine and just kind of give the guys a little bit of an idea of kind of what I look at and what I look for. And hopefully they can take something away from my process, maybe implement, you know, at least one piece into theirs and give them something that kind of puts them over the edge. One thing I wanted to kind of talk to the guys about is with baseball season, especially for the new guys just starting out, because we're getting a lot of them on Twitter that are hitting us up that are just starting, and it's great to see the community growing and how big things are actually getting. But with baseball, it's kind of like college football Saturday every single day. You know, every time you look at the card, you've got, you know, anywhere between 12 to 15 games. And sometimes it can be overwhelming, especially if you kind of fall into the trap of making too many plays. I kind of feel like we did that last night. We started well, hit our big play. Then we had the Dodgers on the card from the get-go, ended up pulling the trigger on them. They left the bat, you know, back in L.A., not a big deal. Took a small loss, we'll make it back today, you know, plus some. But when you get on that roller coaster ride, the only way to steady the ship is to go back to your process. Now, what I've learned after doing this for many years, and again, not saying that my way is the, you know, it's the correct way to do it. It's just something that I've been very successful at, so I'm not trying to change anybody's thought process, just trying to help everyone out. But my way that I've been able to go through is to actually disqualify plays as opposed to looking for plays. I know a lot of times when guys look at the board, you know, they go through and kind of find their favorite matchups. Mine's kind of right the opposite. I go through and I look at the nasty games that I don't want to get involved in, and those games are dead to me, you know, from the get-go unless I get any type of information that brings them back in. So that's kind of one thing that we do a little bit different that might be able to help the guys out. As far as Major League Baseball just concerning itself with the process, basically what we start with is we always start with the starters as far as the matchups that's going on in the game. Yep. That's one of my first qualifiers. If the starters qualify, then I move on to the bullpen. If the bullpen's qualified, then I move on to offensive production. If offensive production qualifies, then I check the weather, the line movement, and the trend. If every single one of those things qualify, then more than likely it's going to be a play for it. Now, you kind of mentioned the run line stuff. What we do like to do, and they've been on fire. I think we've hit 12 out of our last 13 run line parlays.
Awesome.
But basically what we do is we find a very good value on a dog that might have a little bit of a shaky bullpen that we might not be able to trust to get the win or hold on to the lead for us, but that we feel very confident will stay within one run because there are a lot of one-run ball games. You know, this year that we're seeing.
Sure.
A lot of extra inning games that we're seeing this year, a lot more than we've seen last year. So those plays have been very safe for us. One thing that I want to tell the guys is if you get on a fly, because I know a couple guys that are out there that are, you know, trying capping for their first times, and even some of the veterans that, you know, that we kind of go back and forth with have kind of hit a slide, you know, the last couple weeks and caught some tough breaks. When you hit those, don't be afraid to take a day or take 2 days off to kind of refine your process.
Perfect.
Because the only difference between winning and losing on a day-to-day basis is the attitude and approach that you take to handicapping or breaking down those games. That is the only difference. If you go into that approach with a positive, you know, with a positive mental standpoint, looking for the right keys and doing the exact same thing that you did, duplicating the process, then you're going to have good results off of that. And that's what we found just over the years is that any time that me or Tony has got off track and went on a slide, all we've had to do to reset it and get right back on point is just sit down, take a deep breath, look at what we were doing when we were on a hot streak or when we were winning consistently, and get back to that exact process. So not to be too elementary, but in all honesty, guys, when I'm on a hot streak, I will literally keep a diary of my entire day. Not necessarily what I eat or what I do with every step, but just as far as handicapping, exactly how I broke down the game, exactly the order of the operations that I went through. And if I ever hit a slide, I just go back to that page in my book and duplicate that process. And that's what's always been able to get me out of every single slide or every single bad run that I've ever been on. So for the guys that are out there that have maybe hit that slide, or for the guys, even better, if you're hot right now, take the extra 10 minutes to just write down what you've done in that given day that you swept on, or that you went, you know, 4-2 or 5-1 or whatever your day might have been. And write down those steps. And then if you ever do hit a bad streak or ever feel uncertain about something in a given day, just go back to that sheet of paper and duplicate the process. And that's all this is. Now, what I found is that it only takes a solid 4.5 to 5 hours worth of handicapping to be able to do this successfully over the years. Now, it can't be 4.5 to 5 hours straight. You can't wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning, put a solid 5 in, and plan on getting out a good card. But what you can do is you can start the process the night before after all the games are finished, take a look at the ones that you like, disqualify some of the games, so that way you're working with a shorter card as soon as you get up the next morning, and then put in 2 hours at a time throughout the day to determine whether those still qualify as plays or not. Again, not trying to change anybody's thought process or belief, just wanted to share something that hopefully can be long-lasting, you know, with some of these guys that they can kind of take away from this and be able to implement in their daily process.
Got it, man. Got it. You know what? I always say this, dude. Sometimes the best play you made was the one that you never made. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, don't force it. Like, I applaud what you're saying right there, because, dude, it's, you know, like the other night, man, I looked at the card, and on the show, I was like kind of leaning certain ways, but then at the end, I couldn't get a finger on a game that I liked. So I fell back, right? And all the leans that I was going to do that I would have back in the past pushed, they all lost. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it worked out. That was a gambling god's, you know, looking down on me and smiling on their faces. So, no, I agree with you, dude. I mean, and as far as your, you know, 4 to 5 hours of handicapping, you know, I don't spend that much time. I'm not a handicapper anyway, but I'm just saying that. You know, I feel like if you're spending too much time on a game, you start second guessing yourself. Have you found that?
I believe that you definitely can. And the main reason why I say the, you know, as far as the hours, is just because I feel like, I know definitely on our end that we receive different types of information throughout the day. You know, just as far as obviously weather reports, and then the lineup. So that's one of the main things is that, you know, I'm looking at two games today. I looked at them last night. I had them kind of just a pin put in them. Looked at them this morning. They still look pretty good. I'm going to be watching them throughout the day. You know, so it's just kind of one of those things where it might take you 30 to 45 minutes to analyze the lineup and analyze the offensive production from that lineup. Yeah. You know, I know a lot of the guys are looking at, you know, no score first innings and a lot of that stuff. I've heard that on, you know, previous shows. If you're looking at that as a type of prop or even the team totals, we've been very successful on team totals.
Yeah, yeah, I've noticed that.
Any of these websites, either cover scores and odds, there's a million of them out there, but you can actually get a breakdown of offensive production by inning, and you can also get a breakdown of ERA and WHIP by inning per pitcher and by, you know, bullpen. So when you're looking at that type of stuff and you're deciding whether you're going to put money on it or not, you know, those would be two pretty important things that I would want to check out, you know, before I made any type of prop bet or, you know, no score first inning or score first inning, you know, so on and so forth. So that way I've got the best information possible, because it's like I've told, you know, a lot of the guys and a lot of the new members, you know, wins, losses, everything else. After all the money and, you know, power and everything else, after you have everything, the only thing that is ever left is information and time. That's it. That's the only other commodity that, you know, that you can have. So that's one of our main things that we kind of pride ourselves on, is the information we're able to gather, you know, throughout the day and distribute that out, you know, to our clients and to some of the guys that, you know, we go back and forth on Twitter with. And it's been very, very successful for, you know, for us and for a lot of our guys.
Absolutely, man. And as far as no score first innings are concerned, I mean, we got to remember that they are facing the top of the lineup.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? Both teams are facing the best hitters that they have. So, you know, if somebody gets on base, you got the cleanup guy coming up. So, you know what, man? I never really thought that I'd be this much amped for baseball. last year when I started this with Dr. Dan, you know, the baseball ticket, I wasn't feeling it. I mean, I talked all kinds of smack about baseball, but now I'm like totally into it, man.
Well, it's just one of those things that's kind of a ebb and flow of it because, you know, you get used to kind of the college football action, you know, the Thursday, Friday, you know, Saturday, Sunday type deal, you know, early games, unless you're wanting to get involved in, you know, the MAC or WAC or something like that, you know, you're not really playing those games. So you kind of are able to set a routine, and then obviously football is a very excitable sport. I was lucky and blessed enough to, you know, to be a baseball player and just kind of learn the game, and I'm still trying to get back to it now, you know, even at my age, trying to still help out where I can. But it's absolutely beautiful. And then as far as just the sports investing side, it's units for days just because of the number of games that we have. So if you refine your process and you stick to it, and your unit structure definitely, you know, over a long period of time, this can be very, very profitable if you're picking the, you know, if you're picking the right spot.
Absolutely, man. And guys, what I do personally is I keep an Excel spreadsheet. So what I do is I go on, you know, all the different books or whatever. I add up my total and then I put it on, you know, day by day by day. Okay. And, you know, some days it'll be, you know, minus, you know, 3.5%. Other days it'll be up, you know, 8% or 2% or 1% or whatever. And then what I do is I go up and I highlight the entire percentage thing and I see what my average gain per day is. And right now it's, I forgot. I got to look at it recently, but I want to say it was like 2.74%. That's not bad per day. I'm with that.
That's solid.
Yeah.
That's solid.
I'm with it. You know what I'm saying?
3 plays a day is always safe. You know, one of the main things that I've seen on Twitter that we didn't really get on the personal side of our advising with our clients is that a lot of the guys that come to us, you know, kind of come to us starting out and they want to kind of, you know, obviously they want, you know, they want the plays and they want advice. But they're trying to actually learn how to handicap the game themselves. So that's the reason why we've kind of changed our format a little bit to be able to kind of help those guys, you know, to where you can come on for, you know, whether it be a week or a month or whatever else, talk with me and Tony, kind of understand how we do things, how we operate, you know, and then build your bankroll through our path. And then kind of test the waters on your own. And then if it gets too sticky out there for you, you know, you can always come back because all of the prices are affordable and we keep them that way and we do that on purpose.
Yep.
The whole goal was to simplify the process. A lot of folks have kind of, you know, tried to make this as complicated as possible. It's really not. You know, it's just information and how you distribute and use that information and if you can use that information to your advantage. You know, so anything you're doing more than that, you're just complicating your day.
Sure, sure. And like I said, and one thing I want to touch on real quick before we get into the games, how many of your guys, how many of your clients after a winning day hit you up and still want more?
You get that. It's not so much now just because of the interaction that we have with our guys. Now, I can say in the beginning, before we started actually conversing with everybody and kind of going back and forth with them on the email and direct message so that way they kind of understand, you know, how we do things. We would get that, especially if you're hot, you know, they just kind of want some more. It's an addictive, you know, obviously it's an addictive kind of game we're playing here, you know, so I mean money on top of money on top of money. But our guys, we've been, you know, I just can't say it enough, we've been very blessed with everybody that we've had. We don't have many guys coming to sideways after, you know, after a bad night or a bad run. Same way on the good side, you know, we don't have guys out there with pom-poms neither, you know, after a sweep or, you know, something like that, just because they kind of expect it and they know that in the long run, no matter what happens after a day, week, or month, that by the end, we're all at the finish line, we're going to be plus money just because it's been proven, you know, time after time. So we've been very lucky with all of our clients and everybody that has came on board. And I think it's just kind of our approach and, you know, the way that we've taken, you know, kind of the way that we've taken a different kind of approach to advising and being able to really try to help these folks out. Because there's nothing that I love more than being able to middle on a book like what me and you've been able to do the past couple of nights.
Yeah, right.
Where we can hit them both ways. I've got guys that play a lot of personal plays that, you know, hit me up and just ask me, you know, hey, what's your feeling on this? You know, so just love to be able to help them out with that. But, I mean, at the end of the day, I know there's a lot of guys that kind of go back and forth as far as other cappers and other services that kind of, yeah, and, you know, it's kind of a competition. At the end of the day, guys, it's us versus the bookie.
Right.
I mean, you know, we can fight and argue and love on each other all we want to, however you want to do it. But at the end of the day, it's whether we're getting paid by that guy on Tuesday or whether we're having to write him a check on Tuesday.
Yeah.
And personally, I never like paying that cash at all. So, you know, and I try to avoid it at all possibilities. So I'm going to keep winning. You know, and that's what we're concentrating on, and that's what we're doing, you know, over at StraightWinnersVIP.com.
Awesome, dude. Awesome. So, all right, so let's get down to brass tacks here and have a conversation. All right, dude. I am looking at one of the nastiest MLB cards I've seen this year. I got to be honest with you. So for you to have some stuff, you know, I know that you're going to give out something to the audience. How do you want to do this, man? Because I'm looking at this and I'm like, I mean, just real quick. I mean, I'm looking at David Price for the Detroit Tigers as a -170 favorite, which to the Houston Astros, I don't think he has any business giving that kind of juice, to be honest with you. You know, just bouncing around. I'm not going to hold you to any of this stuff. I'm just kind of throwing conversations out there. Have you messed with the Astros at all?
I did. We cashed a couple team totals on them, you know, earlier. I was glad that you got the cash in the early game yesterday. The A's absolutely atrocious. Golly.
Yeah.
I don't know. You know, the past couple games, I think you could put them and the Dodgers in a, you know, in a BP hitting contest, and I don't know if they hit 1 out of 10 pitches. It's been that bad for those guys.
I know.
But the only stuff that I'm – yeah, there is some nasty games early that we've kind of disqualified. I am looking at two, though, one early and one late.
Okay.
And I'm not sure exactly which direction we're going to go. I'm going to watch the line movement because I'm pretty sure the Cardinals are about to be favored here in a minute if they're not already. Anytime that you can get the Cardinals, as good as their bullpen is and offensive production, how it's coming around, anytime you can get them at plus money, it's always a good value just as far as long-term trends over time. Basically, what we're looking at in this one is Garcia's taking Wainwright's spot in the rotation on this. He's coming back from his rehab start. He's 2-0 with 0.94 ERA against the Mets. Just been absolutely dominating his last four starts against those guys. I know the Groom is a stud at home, but I know that the last time that he played the Cardinals, you know, he gave up 6 runs and didn't have too good an outing. I'm definitely looking at the Cardinals in the early game. Now, I don't know exactly what we're going to do with them yet. We're going to watch that line. We might find a way to run line parlay them with something. Like I said, we just had a lot of continued success with that, and it seems to be a lot safer play. But that's one of the things that we're looking at. Because Garcia is 4-0 on the road as a dog. The Groom's 0-4 in his last, you know, in his last four Thursday starts. And the Mets are 0-4 in their last four starts against the left-handers.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just kind of one of those things where the trends are matching up. You know, everything as far as our qualifications with our starter, our bullpen, our offensive production, our weather, line movement, and trends are all matching for this game. So it definitely qualifies as of now. Not saying that it couldn't drop off the card, you know, a little bit later on as we get the finalized lineup after BP. That was another thing that I wanted to say to the guys. I know we've had a lot of guys that have maybe pulled the trigger early on some games. And then the lineups that came out, and their guys aren't starting, you know, and now they're trying to figure out a way how to buy out of it. I don't know what everybody's schedule is, and obviously, you know, time's of the essence. But if you can wait until you get those lineups, it'll help you be a lot more successful and keep you from dropping those one or two games that maybe you pulled the trigger on before the lineups came out. And that might be able to help you.
All right. my man Yoda wants to know, is anybody getting a semi listening to you?
He's a clown, man. He's been with us day one, and he's been with us since the beginning, man. And he's been absolutely awesome.
Oh, I know.
I love chopping up with him in the DM.
He sends me the best photos, man. Hey, listen, you know what? We've been around 300 episodes, and I feel like we have introduced a lot of people to each other in 300 episodes. You know what I mean? So, hey, man, you know what? It's working. That's all I got to say about that. Looking at this game here, looking at this game, Vince, I mean, St. Lucia, you know, I've been doing really well with them, and I'm kicking myself that I didn't take them last night because they did win 9-0 after the Dream told me how dope the Mets were at home. But anyway, you know, I'm looking at this, and I mean, the Mets are 3-7 straight up in the last 10 games, dude. St. Lucia, 15-7 in the last 22. Like you said, I mean, the offensive production, a bullpen. I mean, Wainwright going down was a little, you know, sucks. But other than that, I mean, they're really good. They're going to be there.
They'll be there in October. You know, they'll be one of those teams that'll be around just because of what they can do with their bat and then what they're able to do. I mean, their bullpen, as long as you give them a run lead, you know, and the starter can give you six, their bullpen, you can pretty much lock that up, you know. And that's one thing that you've been able to say about St. Louis for the past couple of years. You know, so I feel pretty confident in them. Like I said, with the guys, anything that we're, you know, talking about, we've been talking about in an open book to everybody, you know. So if you want to hit us up, you know, on the DM or email, you know, and just kind of ask us, definitely when we get a little bit closer to game time, if we're still on it or what direction we decided to go, then, you know, obviously we'll be able to help y'all out with that.
You know, DeGrom has been really bad. But, you know, it's like, you almost think he's due for a decent game, but it's like, how the hell do you bet against St. Lucia? You know what I mean? So I kind of, I mean, it's probably got to be juicy though, getting them +1.5. No.
Well, if we were going to take it, we were going to pair it with someone, and I can actually look and see what it's at right now. But yeah, we would probably pair it with another, you know, undervalued dog. That we feel like we can get to work for us, just because, like I said, with as close as the games have been this year, you know, one run has been huge. And I know a lot of guys have kind of noticed it in this game, especially if they've been following it, you know, for the last 10, 12 years, that we kind of went through the, you know, dead ball era and everybody kind of fell off of, you know, baseball after the strike, and, you know, free agency was one of the big killers too for, you know, for the game. And then you had the steroid era that came through, and then it kind of brought everybody back to it because you had the home run race and, you know, all of that stuff. But then as an adverse side effect to it, you know, obviously when everything came out about the steroids and everything, you know, kind of went away from baseball. Again, everybody kind of turned back to the NFL and NBA and, you know, all of that stuff. But what you're seeing now is I think they haven't officially announced that they changed the baseball. But if you look at some of the home runs that some of these guys are hitting, especially staying down in Miami, those balls aren't supposed to travel that far.
Yeah, right.
You know, and
right.
The high scoring games that you're seeing, you know, I feel like they've wound the balls a little bit tighter, which is nothing, you know, nothing wrong with it, because just runs put fans in the stands, you know. So I'm all about it if it helps the game out and we're still making money off of it, then it's, you know, lovely for me. But yeah, you're looking at that anywhere from -185 all the way to -195. So we have kind of just a general rule as far as our side goes with MLB and really with any sport, is that we don't pay juice over 140.
Okay.
On anything. I know that's kind of difficult to do when dealing with a baseball, you know, dealing with baseball and hockey and, you know, some of those guys. But it's just kind of been a rule of thumb for us that we put in place a long time ago that has helped us save money. So if we do get something that's juiced over 140, either number one, it automatically is a play for it. Or number two, we're going to find another safe spot to pair that with to be able to get it at plus money. So that's our kind of rule of thumb with anything over 140 juice on that stuff.
Well, you know what? I actually, you know, my style is a little bit different. I don't mind giving that kind of juice, as you know. That's kind of what our show, you know, has come to.
Yeah.
But you know what? Hey, listen, I understand, though, for the challenge of a handicapper to, you know, to be able to sell that to a client to take a -185 and put $1,800 on it. You know
right.
what I'm saying? To win a G note, they're probably like, oh, I could have did that, you know, whatever. But I've implemented that in my style. Like I said, I consider myself a sophisticated player, not a handicapper. So you know what I like to do all that stuff, and like yesterday I gave the 170 with the Houston Astros, man. I just didn't care. So your -140 is your criteria.
Yeah, and we'll see. So what we were looking at is, you know, we had one of our one of our guys, and I'll give him a shout out. He's been one of our day ones, and I know he's big in SBTV Nation, Smokey Rodriguez. you know, that was listening to the show, you know, along with a lot of other folks, you know, heard you on the Astros, you know, hit me up and asked me, you know, hey, how do you feel about it? You know, so on and so forth. And I told him, I said, I really like to play. I just can't pay the juice. You know, why don't we do something with it? Why don't we either pair it with the Tigers to get it at plus money, or why don't we pair it with the Rangers run line to get it at plus money? And no matter which way he went with that decision, whether he took just the, you know, the Stros and the juice, or paired it with one of those teams for plus money, he's still cash. You know, so there's always, no matter what your approach is, you know, no matter what your style, because there's a million different ways to, you know, to do this and make money. The main thing is to just make sure that your process, that you can duplicate it. Whatever this process might be, whenever you're winning, make sure that you can duplicate that process day in and day out, and you will be successful.
All right, cool deal. All right, so you're feeling St. Lucia on a run line plus 1.5, and you're thinking about pairing that with something. What other game are you looking at, brother?
Yeah, so the late game that I'm looking at, or it's not the late game, it's the afternoon game, would be the Angels versus the Jays. Here you are still getting the Angels at plus money, I believe, if it's still
I got minus 105 over here, but
yeah. So see, they're already moving, and that line's going to flip. So the guys that know me personally, that have been able to kind of talk with me through the email and through the DM, know that I was blessed enough to be able to play baseball collegiately and to be able to have a cup of coffee and spend about 9 months in a lower level minor league organization. Now. The only reason I was able to do that is because I was a left-handed knuckleball pitcher. So one of my ends that I've always had over the years is being able to look at our knuckleball pitchers, which we had Tim Wakefield. Obviously, he's retired now, but now our new one is, you know, R.A. Dickey. And being able to have a little bit of inside information as far as the weather approach to being a knuckleball pitcher. Now, the one thing that I always look for in my starts was that I wanted, number one, I wanted the wind to hit me in the face, and I wanted it to be anywhere between 5 to 10 miles an hour. So kind of right the opposite of a normal pitcher, I wanted the wind to be blowing out. Another thing that I had to have in order to be very successful is I had to have high humidity.
Okay.
So every time that I had to travel up north, obviously that hurt the movement of my baseball, because anybody who understands how a knuckleball works or how any type of off-speed breaking pitch works is how the seams bite against the wind, which creates the movement of the baseball.
Okay.
So what we're looking at with Dickey, and we've been very, very successful either playing on or fading Dickey at the right times this year. I think we're 3-1. I'll have to go back and check the records, but I think we're 3-1 just playing on Dickey, literally handicapping him against the weather. And if we're looking at what's going on in Toronto this afternoon, and it's going to be game times at 7, so we're looking at the humidity is only going to be at 36%. Your wind's going to be west-southwest at 11. That's going to be a crosswind blowing from the third base dugout to the first base dugout. So there is going to be no clear advantage for Dickey this afternoon, because when we're looking at a humidity rate for a knuckleball pitcher or a big breaking ball pitcher, we want that humidity rate to be above 58%. Reason being is when the air's a little bit heavy, the ball's heavier. You know, makes it move a little bit more, makes it dance a little bit more, misses more bats, you get more ground balls, more double plays, less runs, so on and so forth. So what we're looking at in this one is that not only are the Angels 10-2 in their fourth game of the series and 12-1 in their last 13, or in Shoemaker's 12-1 in the last 13 road starts, but also with the way the weather's kind of setting up, the way the line movement kind of moving in our favor, Dickey's 1-5 on 5 days rest and 1-8 on Thursday. I think we're going to be more than comfortable backing the Angels here to just go ahead and beat Toronto 3 out of 4. Still looking at, there's going to be some runs scored. Obviously, it's Toronto. Might look at a first five, so that way we don't fall victim to Joey Bats and them if they get at the bullpen, you know, later on and maybe a 4-3 or 4-2 ball game. So we'll be looking at, you know, first five. Might be able to pair, you know, say a run line first five with our, you know, with our Cardinals and make that work. You know, that would pay out, you know, even money, if not plus money, you know, on something like that. If you catch the line before it flips. But in all honesty, I think you're going to see by first pitch, your Angels are going to be favored, and more than likely your Cardinals are going to be favored, you know, in this. So if those guys are looking at those lines and they really like it and like the approach that we're taking, as soon as you get your lineups and, you know, feel that your guys are starting that you want to start and you feel comfortable about it, I would say go ahead and pull the trigger because you'll get the best value right then, as opposed to waiting, you know, right the first pitch, because I feel like those lines are going to flip.
Got it. Got it. You know what? If I can get this game down to 8, I really like the over in this matchup, but I don't believe that there's only a couple of books, and I don't think I have enough steam on them to get it down to 8, so I may have to fall back from this. But guys, if you can get this game down to 8, I think that an overplay is the play here. And you said it's you think it's going to be like a 4-2 though, huh?
Well, I'm just saying 4-2 early, you know, I mean, before you get to the bullpen, you know, so I mean, maybe looking 4-2 in the 6th. I don't think Dickey goes more than 5, in all honesty. He's, you know, this has been a rough year for him. He really hasn't been, you know, met form, you know, for a while since he's been in Toronto. He's had a, you know, had a couple good starts that we've been able to profit off of. But it's just kind of one of those things to where when you're a victim to circumstances outside of your control, like the weather and the wind, you know, some of those things you just really can't help, you know. So, I mean, you can't change the way the wind's blowing. You can't change the way the stadium's set up.
Right.
You can't change the humidity rate. You know, so if I know his ball's going to be a little flat, I know it's going to float, you know, then there's going to be runs scored. So the over and shoemaker's not, you know, anything to shake his head either. I think his ERA is somewhere, you know, it's over 5.6. You know, so there will be some runs scored, and I think the over would be safe. If you could get it to 8, it might go down to 8. Before it gets there. Like I said, that's the 7 o'clock or 7:07 first pitch. You know, so you've definitely got some time on that one. It's already dropped from 9 to 8.5 anyway.
Yeah. That's the thing, guys. So that would be my recommendation, not 8.5. If we can get it down to 8 and pay a little bit more juice, then that's what we would do and take the over on that. So, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to play it or not. I'll be honest with you. I almost got caught yesterday with a game. I was actually fortunate enough to get the line down to 7 in the Nasties and Stanks game. But let me take a look here. I'm not seeing any 8s yet. So anybody, guys, if you can find an 8-point total on that at some point, send me a DM, send me an email, whatever. Let me know which book offers that because I may go and get it. So, but right now we're at 8.5. I'm looking at that 8 number. That's the one I really, really want. Even if I can buy it down and pay like, you know, -140 or whatever, I'll do that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
All right. So, yeah, dude, taking a look at the rest of the MLBs. My God, kid. This is one of the hardest cards I've seen yet. And guys, we are not going to force it. If there's something that you can learn from this show, man, it's not to chase and not to force. So just looking at these other ones, man, I've got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 day games. So I'm sure all the junkies are going to be checking their phones at work. I mean, you got the LA Dodgers coming into the San Francisco Giants, a 3:45 start. You got Kershaw versus Bumgarner. It seems like they always want to pair these two, huh?
Yeah, that'll be a fun one. That'll be a really fun one to watch. It's hard to go against Bumgarner at home. You know, I know the Dodgers are bound to bounce back and bound to find their bat somewhere. It's going to be hard to go against Bumgarner at home, especially if you're getting plus money. I mean, that value there is set alone. I mean, totals is 6, so you're going to have a low scoring game. But that would be fun to watch just from a baseball. If you're a fan of the game and definitely a fan of pitching, then you know, that's definitely going to be a good one to watch right there.
I want to say this is the 4th time they've gone against each other this year, dude.
I believe it is.
Yeah, so, and I want to say, guys, if you're thinking no score first inning, I can tell you right now that you are 1-2 playing the no score first inning with that matchup. So I suggest you fall back from that.
Definitely.
All right, so, you know, looking at the diamond, I got to be honest with you guys. Hey, you know, go on all the respective websites out there or whatever. Take a look at the matchups. Take a look at the stats. I am looking at this. I mean, we're already close to 10 o'clock. I don't see anything that makes me excited at all. I mean, you got Clay Buchholz pitching for Boston. Boston -165 with an under-over of 8.5. Dude, Clay Buchholz has no business giving -165 juice at all. And I can't recommend you taking Texas there. You got Philadelphia, Colorado, you've got, Oakland, Tampa Biscuit. I mean, dude, I applaud you for finding a couple of games out of this mess.
Yeah, it's just one of those. It's just kind of tread lightly. I mean, there's going to be plenty of spots. I mean, this isn't the only day that they play the game, you know, so we're definitely fortunate in that. So it's one of those things where if you can find a good end, you know, get your money in quick, be safe with it. You know, obviously exercise your unit structure. That's another thing that, you know, if these guys aren't out there definitely trying to put together a unit structure, it needs to be something that you develop in your daily routine to make sure that you're investing for long term as opposed to just for a week or a month, because if you do go on a slide and you don't have an appropriate unit structure, then you're out of money. You can't play anymore, you know, so
right.
That's no fun for anybody.
Right.
But yeah, just tread lightly. I mean, like I said, if you can find a couple winners on the board today, and there might be some totals and some team totals whenever they come out, that might be better spots than what we were looking at early. Again, it's just about your process. So that's the main thing that I wanted to convey to all the guys, that if you haven't developed a routine yet, or you haven't, you know, really tried to figure out what you're doing and what's successful, just take a minute and just write it down and figure it out from there. And then that way you always have a point to go back to, and something always to bring any type of positivity, you know, into your day. That's the main thing. Just always try to start things positive, help folks out, and good things will happen to you.
Absolutely, man. Absolutely. So are you doing any hoop or NHLs? Because I've only seen you send me baseball.
Yeah, no, I had a small play on the Hawks last night. I hope they would get it done, you know, game one. Obviously, you know, it didn't happen. LeBron and company, well, the Smith and company last night.
Yeah, right.
Absolutely lit it up. You know, praying for my boy, Gerald. One thing, you know, him and Tony actually used to play ball, you know, together back in the day, back when they were kids. So I know that, he was holding his breath a little bit last night whenever he went down. You know, so praying for him to have a speedy recovery and, you know, just hope those guys stay healthy out there.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're taking a look at this. You got Houston versus Golden State tonight. Golden State's minus 10 with an under-over of 220, kid. They're expecting fireworks here offensively yet again. And I got to be honest with you, dude. James Harden had a hell of a game. I mean, he is a hell of an athlete. I know he gets a lot of credit from most, but some don't like him. Klay Thompson was all up in his ass, and he still was hitting shots left and right, man. So I don't expect to see anything different here. But, I mean, you know, you leave Steph Curry underneath the bucket by himself with no defense on him. I mean, he's going to make the layup.
Right.
So unless they make that adjustment, I think Houston's in big trouble here, and I think I'm in big trouble with my Houston futures.
Well, I mean, you should be able to, you know, to find a way to kind of to hedge out of it, you know, sometime during the series. I try to stay away from the 3-point spread either way. It's either dog or pass, you know, especially if you're looking at double digits. You know, but I mean, this is playoff basketball, and you're still seeing these, you know, crazy numbers like that. So, you know, it's just one of those things where if we feel good about the Rockets, we might be able to pull the trigger on something like that. But, again, it's just one of those things where, you know, Golden State scores faster than any team that I've ever seen since I've been watching basketball.
Cool.
You know, and can dissolve a deficit quicker than any team that I've ever seen.
Dude,
so
they were
one of those things where you can be up, you know, with even the 10-point spread, you can be up by 20 with 5-6 minutes left and, you know, still not cash that ticket. So,
yeah.
So it's one of those things where we've been successful with MLB, and that's where we've kind of, you know, just stuck with, haven't really dabbled, you know, a lot in the hoop. Especially this series or the one before, just because they've been sneaky and they've been getting a lot of folks.
Absolutely, man. I mean, as far as the live lines are concerned, I watch them throughout the entire game, and I actually have like 6 books open while I'm doing it all at the same time, because I like to see, you know, if I'm overpaying for one or not, and I try to get the best and all that. But when the Houston Rockets were up 16 points, they were only a minus 130 favorite, dude. Up 16 points. That's how much respect they have for Golden State. And obviously it was apparent there. You know what I mean?
Right. I mean, it's just one of those things where it's fun to watch, but I don't like to have money on it.
No way.
I can sit down with a beer, you know, with the fellas and enjoy watching a, you know, a fast-paced game and something fun, but I don't want to invest anything on that. Not right now.
Yeah, definitely. And shoot, so I don't have an opinion on that game, guys. I mean, if anything, they're really adjusting the totals. I mean, up to 220 now. That's a lot of points. I don't have an opinion there. I'm going to kind of fall back and watch. I'd love to see Houston steal a game here. I just don't think that they're going to be able to. I mean, Golden State is 23-1 in the last 24 games at home, and the only loss was to Memphis.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like, how do you bet against a team like that? You know, if anything, if you have an open parlay or whatever, maybe, you know, if you got it has to be like a four teamer to make any money. But, you know, throw them in on the money line. I don't see you getting hurt there, to be honest with you. And scrolling over to the ice, dude, do you do any hockey or no?
No hockey for me. I know there's a lot of good guys out there. Real deal DJ, you know, does some good stuff. He sends me a lot of really good hockey winners, but it's just been one of those things where, you know, hockey's kind of ran into, you know, kind of the end of football and start of basketball and then start of baseball. So it's been one of those where we've had enough action to where we've never really had to go there, you know, and really make that a part of our portfolio.
Yeah, guys, and I'm going to recommend that you follow, you know, check out the Queen of Odds with the hockey. She's been absolutely ripping it up. You've got her, you got the Total Sports Edge, you got my man Hockey Immortal. I mean, there's a lot of people out there. So, you know, definitely check them out and see what they got going on with this Anaheim Ducks and Chicago Blackhawks. Chicago Blackhawks minus 140. I did manage to slip them into a future, so now I have all four teams, so I can't lose. You know, with the series tied 1-1, I was actually able to put them in a parlay, which is going to pay nuts.
Right.
So, yeah. So, I mean, I got all my ends covered here, but you know, the Rangers were my best shot at 18-1, but you know, now that they're down 2-1, I think they fall down 3-1. I don't think it's going to be the same result as the Washington series.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, all right, my man, Vince Parker. Tell the world where to find you, kid, and what you got as far as your website is concerned, and then we'll get the hell out of here, man.
Yeah, so you can find us on Twitter and follow me and Tony. You can follow me on Twitter at VinceParker16. My partner, Tony Tupix, is at Tony Tupix. Funny story about our website. We kind of broke things down and simplified a lot of things to where we're doing a lot of stuff ourselves now, as opposed to, you know, bringing other people in to do it. So, I actually tried my hand at building a website or building our own website. Didn't do too good a job of it. So I had to kind of start over and redo one. So our website now is straightwinnersvip.com. The entire goal of our service, guys, is to simplify the process and keep things affordable for the everyday guy out there that wants to learn how to make a little bit of money sports investing as opposed to just throwing money against the wall or, you know, throwing money on stuff that he might not have a lot of confidence in. And if we can help you out and kind of help you understand our thought process through the, you know, through everything, then it's a win-win for everybody because we're all going to cash tickets at the end of the day regardless.
Awesome, dude. And my boy, the Canadian Capper, just told me that you could actually find this total in the Toronto game at 8 at minus 129 juice. And 7.5 at 138. So that leads me to believe that the line is going to come down, dude.
Yeah, if one book's already offering it.
Yeah, so the Canadian Capper, check him out, man. But Vince, awesome breakdown, dude. You know what I mean? Like, the Dream and I, you know, we go back and forth. You know what I'm saying? We don't go in depth like you do with these games. You know what I mean? We kind of, you know, it's more, you know, my style is more instinctual. And then I take a look at the, you know, the pitchers, the weather, the rosters, blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? But I don't break it down as much as you do because, like I said, I'm not a handicapper. But I give you a lot of credit for your trade. And I look forward to seeing your plays again, man.
Well, man, I appreciate the time and the opportunity. I appreciate all the guys out there at SBPD Nation. Y'all guys have been awesome to us and just can't thank y'all enough. If you're interested in anything that we offer, even if it's just asking questions about plays, do not hesitate to hit me or Tony up and let us help you, you know, let us help you make some money. That's what we're here to do and that's what we're about.
All right, man. That's Straight Winners, right? Straightwinners.com?
Straightwinnersvip.com.
All right, straightwinnersvip.com. All right, send that out. I'll send it out to the nation, and this way they can follow you and go from there. Vince, thank you so much for calling on episode 300. We appreciate it, brother.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, take care. All right, guys, so that is going to do it for the show, man. What a wild ride today, man. I had an absolute blast with you guys. I'm telling you, I mean, you've heard my voice 300 times. And, you know, that doesn't include YouTube and the videos we've done and all that. But I got news for you, man. We've got some stuff in the works here that is going to put this show on the map. So I just want to tell you that I just want to, from the bottom of my heart again, thank you, SBTV Nation, for making this show what it is. And I promise you, I will work my ass off to make it bigger and better by the day, nonstop. So, guys, we are Sports Bettors TV. We are the biggest show in the world, period. You're going to follow us on all social media outlets. We are on Facebook. We are on Twitter. We are on Instagram. We are on Google+. We are on Tumblr. I've been putting my plays on there as well. Sports Bettors TV and SportsBettorsTV.com. Guys, go out there. Go easy. Bet your own homework. Bet your own homework. Do your own homework. Bet your own plays and get that money. Take care.